Pneumatics, similar to motors, can be used to move parts of your robot. However, they have several key differences. Motors can spin clockwise and counterclockwise, while pneumatics can only be extended or retracted. Pneumatics are also entirely separate from the 88-watt motor limit, which you could leverage to your advantage if you're clever. Let's explain how pneumatics work. This tank is similar to a battery, except that it stores air pressure, which is used to push and retract these pistons or cylinders. The higher the pressure, the higher the force of the piston. However, with each extension and retraction, pressure will be consumed, decreasing the force of the piston. Here, I am using a shutoff valve to control the piston. We should align the arrow the way the air will move. To close the valve, rotate it so it's perpendicular to the airflow. To open it back up, have it be in line with the airflow. To increase the tank's pressure again, you can use an air pump. Electric ones are the most common, but in a pinch, you can even use a bike pump. Remember that in the VEX Robotics competitions, you cannot exceed 100 PSI. If the tank is a battery, fittings and tubings are the wires. These straight and 90-degree fittings just screw onto whatever pneumatic part you need. The tubing can just be pushed into the fitting. It will lock into the tubing to prevent it from being pulled out. To take the tubing back out, push on the red cap and pull. If you can hear or feel hissing, the fitting likely wasn't screwed on enough. Once you know how long your tubing should be, use this tubing cutter. Align the tubing and push down. Remember to account for the tubing that goes into the fitting so you can leave a little slack. Say you wanted to measure the exact PSI as the piston fires. For this, you'll need a T-fitting and an air pressure gauge. The way you plug in the T-fitting doesn't actually matter, so do what makes the most sense for your robot. The T-fitting and the elbow fitting actually have holes so you can attach zip ties to your robot for tube management. Another important use of the T-fitting is to connect two air tanks, allowing your system to maintain a higher pressure for longer. Earlier, I said that the force of the piston would decrease as pressure decreased. However, this doesn't have to be the case, thanks to the air pressure regulator. Say your tank is at 80 PSI. Using the air pressure regulator, we could have the piston consistently fire at only 50 PSI. However, once the tank dips below 50, the strength of the piston will again go down to zero. Having the regulator ensures the piston is more consistent, but also lets it be used more often as it consumes less pressure. To use it, first make sure everything is plugged in correctly. Next to the white hexagon piece, there is an arrow. The tube from the tank should go into the side with the arrow. To set the pressure, pull on the knob and rotate it. Counterclockwise to decrease the pressure, clockwise to increase the pressure. At the very end, don't forget to push the knob back in. The kit also comes with components for securely attaching the pressure regulator to your robot. First, undo this plastic nut. Then attach the metal bracket. Then screw the nut back on. You can use a screwdriver to screw in some screws through these holes. The airflow valve sounds similar to the air pressure regulator, but they do two different things. The airflow valve controls the speed at which the piston moves, not its pressure. Turning the knob out increases the speed, but turning the knob in decreases it. At the very end, similar to how you have to push in the knob of the regulator, you have to screw this in to lock it in. Finally, get to the star of the show, the air cylinders or pistons. The official VEX kit comes with three types. The small 25mm piston, the 50mm piston, and the 75mm piston. The stroke length is how far the piston can extend. you'll have to decide which ones to use on a case-by-case basis. Control the pistons from the braid, use these solenoids. On each side of the solenoid, you'll see ports marked P, where the fitting should be attached. There are wires that plug into the solenoid on one end, and the three-wire ports on the brain on the other. The black and red go onto the left side, while the white and green go onto the right side. As you can see on the solenoid, there is an A side and a B side. The B side on the right is used to extend the piston, while the A side on the left is used to push in the piston. If you're only using one solenoid, use this plug to prevent any excess air from leaking out. However, if you're using two solenoids, you can plug it in like this. Here's an example configuration where multiple pistons are powered by the same solenoid. And here's a configuration where two solenoids independently operate their own pistons. If you learned anything from this video, please like and subscribe. If you still have any questions, leave a comment down below. Thanks for watching.